triangles. Welcome all of you to another maths class. In the last video, we just started the subtopic Pythagoras theorem in chapter triangles. And in the last video, we already discussed one important theorem. That theorem we will use today to prove Pythagoras theorem. So in this video, we are going to give a proof for Pythagoras theorem.
So first of all, we all know Pythagoras theorem. What is Pythagoras theorem? In a right triangle, sum of the squares of the smaller sides will be equal to the square of the largest side. In other terms, the hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of the perpendicular sides. Okay, so here you have seen some proof in 9th standard, but here using the idea of similar triangles, we will give a proof for the Pythagoras theorem.
This is the theorem we discussed in the last class with proof. We will use this theorem to prove Pythagoras theorem in this video. This theorem says that
if a perpendicular is drawn from the vertex of right angle of a right triangle to the hypotenuse, then triangles on both sides of the perpendicular are similar to the whole triangle and to each other. Okay.
This is Pythagoras theorem. We can state Pythagoras theorem like this.
In a right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. That means the squares of the perpendicular sides. Okay. So we'll give a proof now. Okay. So I shall take picture. Okay. I draw a picture like this. Okay. Suppose this ABC. I give name like this ABC, and this angle is 90 degrees. Suppose angle C is 90 degrees. We choose like so, and we use the previous theorem to prove the Pythagoras theorem. We want to prove that the square of the hypotenuse, that is AB square, is equal to what we have to prove. AB square is equal to
AC square plus B.
AC square plus
BC square.
Yes, Pythagoras theorem. So for that, we draw a perpendicular from the right angle, from that 90 degree angle to the opposite side. To the opposite side means to the hypotenuse. So we draw a perpendicular. Okay. So we can give a name here, suppose P here. So as we proved just before, we can see that triangle APC will be similar to the large triangle. Large triangle ABC, you give name in the same order of corresponding angles. So angle A, this angle corresponds to which angle of the large triangle? So I don't write 90x and 90 minus x, etc. Like so. Simply look.
What did you ask?
So we apply the previous theorem. We just before we have seen that the triangle on the left side, triangle APC, will be similar to the large triangle, right? Okay, so I wrote the name of this small triangle in the left side as triangle APC. So that is similar to the large triangle. So I don't simply name ABC the large triangle, because we have to take the name in the same order of corresponding angles. So angle A corresponds to which angle of the large triangle? Okay, so we can start with the angle AA, then second name P. Angle P in this small triangle, that is 90 degree. So which is the 90 degree angle in the large triangle?
C.
So we can give name like this. Triangle APC and triangle ACB are similar. That is, when the perpendiculars are drawn, the triangle formed in the left side is similar to the whole triangle, the large triangle. Yes, that we will write here. Okay. The triangle on the right side, how you can name? I think the same order we can give name. Similar to triangle ACB, we want to get same. So how we can name the triangle on the right side? Corresponding angles should be
BPC.
BPC.
We want to start from C, right?
CPB.
90 degree comes second, so CPB. Okay, so we give a name like this. Triangle CPB, triangle CPB is similar to triangle ACB. Triangle ACB means the large triangle. So look here, since these triangles are similar, we can apply the corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Second statement in the definition, since they are similar, the corresponding sides will be in the same order, same ratio. Okay, look here. So in the small triangle, I choose AP. So AP divided by in large triangle, which corresponds to AP. AP by what will come in large triangle?
AC.
AC, yeah. Right? Why? Because AP is the smallest side of the triangle in the left side, that is triangle APC. So what will be the smallest side in this large triangle? That will be AC, right? So AP by AC is equal to, AP by AC is equal to, now you choose AC in the small triangle in the left side. AC divided by which side will correspond in the large triangle?
AB.
AB, right? Here in the small triangle, AC is the hypotenuse, right? In triangle APC, AC is the hypotenuse. So in the large triangle also, you want to take the hypotenuse, the largest side. So that is AB. Okay. So I think next step also we can write here. So you simply cross multiply. What will you get? AP into AB is equal to AC.
AC square.
AC square. AC square. Okay. In right side, we have to do similar steps. So a triangle CPB is similar to triangle ACB. So I take sides like this. So we don't want CP. We don't want CP. So first we can take a BP. So BP by what will come? In small triangle, I choose BP, the triangle in the right side.
CB,
which corresponds
to CB.
CB.
The larger triangle.
CB.
CB is BC. So same. Okay. CB and BC are same. C equal to, then we take this. We need the hypotenuse. So we take BC in the right side. Right side triangle.
AB.
The larger triangle, the hypotenuse.
AB.
AB. Okay. Now you cross multiply. What will you get? BP into AB is equal to
BC square.
Okay. Now you add this 1 and 2. 1 plus 2. What will you get? 1 plus 2. AP into AB plus BP
into
AB is equal to AC square plus BC square. AC square plus BC square. So here in left side, you can take AB outside the bracket. AB outside the bracket. So how will come? AB into AP plus
BP
equal to AC square plus BC square. So now what's inside the bracket? AP plus BP. What is AP plus BP?
AB.
AB, right? So AB into AB. AB into AB is C equal to AC square plus BC square. So we got the result, right? AB into AB is AB square.
AB
square. AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square. This is Pythagoras theorem, right? We wrote in the beginning here. AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square. We proved. AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square. We got. Okay. So I repeat again. So we only take the ratios of two sides. So there is one more side, we didn't care about the CP of the small triangles. In both small triangles, there is a side CP. We don't choose that because we don't want that. Okay, so from these two sides, after cross multiplication, then add these two equations, we'll reach into AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square. Small proof only. So, but you should be very careful when you take these sides. If a small mistake if you made, then you won't reach in this result. You will become more confused. So your picture should be correct. Otherwise, if it doesn't look like 90 or something, like any problem in the picture, you will be confused. We don't have to take the similarity of small two triangles, but we don't want. In the proof, there should be a picture. In the proof, there should be a picture. A right triangle need not be in the same way. You can also draw like this, no problem. You can draw a triangle like this, no problem. You will get the same result. In any order, you can give name. no problem.
But the right angle that is even, sir.
Need not be. Any name you can give. Yeah, and the Pythagoras theorem will be also change. And the final result will also come to the that same. Okay. Any right triangle you can choose. Suppose I take here K, M. Okay. So you take one each small triangle with the larger triangles. The similarity. Okay. The small two triangles are also similar, that we don't care here. We don't want here. Okay. So triangle we can draw anyhow. You want to draw the perpendicular for 90 degree angle to the opposite side and give some name. And you finally, if you take the same steps, you'll finally reach here Mn square is equal to Km square plus Kn square. Okay. For this theorem, you want to study the proof. It's very important for this Pythagoras theorem proof. Previous theorem, that's not much important, but anyway, you study because we proved this theorem using the previous theorem. Sometimes you may get a question like this. In a triangle, a perpendicular is drawn from the to the 90 degree angle. From the right angle, a perpendicular drawn to the opposite side. Prove that the two triangles formed, the left side and right side, are similar. So not like proving the theorem, but as a problem, you may have to solve that. No. You can apply this theorem directly. You can simply start. We have triangle APC similar to triangle ACB and triangle, and these two you can simply directly write. Just to mention here, since CP is perpendicular to AB, we have triangle APC similar to triangle ACB and these two. Then continue. No need to prove both. Okay. So this is the Pythagoras theorem. There's one more name for the Pythagoras theorem, Baudin theorem. Baudin theorem. Okay. Baudin is a mathematician, Indian mathematician, who lived in around BC 800. But the Pythagoras lived only in BC 500 something. So he invented this theorem a little bit before, right? He mentioned the theorem like this. The diagonals of a rectangle produced by itself the same area as produced by its both sides. Actually, it gives some hints to the Pythagoras theorem. I think almost the same. The diagonal of a rectangle produces by itself the same area as produced by its both sides. This means like this. Suppose a rectangle here and a diagonal here. The area produced by this diagonal means the area of a square having this diagonal as a side. The area of this square is same as sum of the areas produced on the sides of this rectangle. That is, if you consider only this right triangle ABC, if you try consider the right triangle ABC, the BC square, that is the area produced by BC, that is same as the sum of the areas produced by AB and AC. Area produced by AB will be this area, this square's area, and area produced by AC will be this area. So sum of these two areas will be area of this square. So this gives some direct hint to the Pythagoras theorem. He didn't mention for a right triangle, but this is very close to Pythagoras theorem, right? The term, just to note it, Baudin theorem. Baudin theorem. So the Pythagoras theorem, we can also name Baudin theorem. Okay.
The next theorem is just reverse of Pythagoras theorem. That we can discuss in the next video.